Welcome back. The Play Here Sinlaw campaign continues. Today we're busy with Forts Randolph and Bulow. They will be here hosting a Dutch oven cooking event this weekend. Richard Holloway is with us and he will give us a little demonstration today.
Yes, ma'am. Richard. Oh, you're welcome. You know, the average soldier back then, when they ate in a group, they used a Dutch oven because it had a lot of food. But mainly the soldier, if he was on his own, would just use an individual skillet, just like this one right here. And what we're having today is a simple fare that a soldier would have that's available at any time in a garden that they would grow near the fort.
Okay.
And we grow these radishes in the garden, and they are absolutely wonderful. And everybody just uses a radish for a salad.
Right.
And it's more than that. And in fact, I've come up with about 25 different recipes to make it quite interesting.
Is that right?
Yes, ma'am.
I know about salads. That's about all I know.
Well, the best one that I've come up with, especially for demonstration purposes, which they would have done back then, is to do a nice sautéed in butter and onions radish. And what you do is you get your nice onions all chopped up, and you put it in there in your skillet, and you get the nice radish. Now, everybody, you know, usually throws the greens away when they have a radish, and you can eat these greens. They're actually really good.
Really? Okay.
Yeah. And I don't bother to cut the root off or anything like that.
So you're using the entire radish?
The entire radish. And you try to cut it this way so that you always have a little bit of red showing.
Gotcha.
Okay.
Now, this is also a really good Christmas type of decoration. And what you would do is when you start your cooking, you have your radish and you have your greens. Well, what you do is you cook your radish first. You saute that with your onions, and then you wait, and then you put the greens in later because you don't want them to lose their color. So you put them in sort of last.
Sure.
And actually, at Christmas time, this is wonderful because it's a red and green combination. You put it on the table, and people love it. But yeah, just easily slice up a radish. Leave the whole thing on there, chop it all up. We're going to put this in a little bit early. Now, I've already prepared some for y'all to have a taste with.
That's what I'm talking about.
Put it in there. And
Mark?
Absolutely. Now, while you're cutting away over here, I want to let our viewers know that we've been smelling this for the last 30 minutes. And so if we've looked a little distracted on air, this is why.
But check out the fork. Now, tell us this.
This is actually a Spanish fork that has history here in central Louisiana. This was also the Spanish post-rapido.
Post-rapido.
Yeah, everybody covers the French history here, but not a lot of people cover the Spanish history.
Okay.
And that's a Spanish fork. And it would be something to be available even during the Civil War times because you don't get rid of anything.
So unique.
It really is unique. It really is. That's actually sort of unusual. Because of the three tines on it.
Yes, I see that. And what are the initials here?
That is just the crest of the family that owned and made the fork.
Really? Okay.
So sort of interesting little thing. But yeah, give it a try. And it's really a nice little vegetable that you can have. And I mean, look at how simple this is to do. And you're going to go and just saute it all and put it on your plate. And this is your vegetable.
Now, how do you maintain? How long have you had your pot?
That pot's probably been around about 25 years.
25 years, yeah. So it's well seasoned.
It's well seasoned. It used to be, I think, a silvery color like this, but it just sort of worked into black. But, you know, it works out better
well,
that way.
There you go.
And same with cast iron cooking, except this, you don't have to season this one because this is a steel skillet. So you don't have to worry about that. But, yes, it's really good.
Yes.
Thank you so much for being naturally curious right now, because I'm having breakfast this one.
This is your breakfast?
It's really good.
Well, yeah,
it's fantastic.
No offense, but when you start a dish with onions and butter,
you can't go wrong.
Yeah, yeah, and I'm going to tell you that most people think that the radish, you know, is again just for salads. This vegetable was one of the very first that they brought to the Americas. It originated around in Asia.
Really?
And in fact, Japan still has a 100-pound radish, which I can not imagine how much butter it would take to saute that thing.
Well, so tell us a little bit about Fort Polk and Randolph. Everything's going well for you?
Yes, ma'am. We're doing just fine over there. And in fact, this weekend we have our Dutch oven cooking. And if you come out, and if you're between 13 and 61, you pay the $4 admission. If you're under or over that, it's free. And the food is free. I mean, what more
And the food's delicious.
What more can you ask for?
Thank you so much for being with us this morning.
Oh, you're welcome.
Hey,
thank you guys so much. More Good Day Sinlock coming up just after this.